Hi, I'm Vashi Nedomansky, feature film editor and co-founder of Vashi Visuals. In this video today, the third video and final in this series on color calibration, I'm actually going to show you how I color calibrate my monitors, and it involves techniques using both software and hardware. I'm also going to recommend which color space, which color gamut is best for what kind of creative work you're doing. If you're a photographer or a graphic designer or a documentarian or a music video director or a feature film editor, there's different kinds of color spaces and gamuts you should consider and use the best one that's appropriate for your work so the end result is as accurate and beautiful and representative of your work as it can be. As we discussed before, the objective of color calibration is to have color accurate results and colors that are repeatable and that hit an industry standard. So you know that what you've created as your final product, no matter what discipline or art form you're doing, it will look the same on someone else's computer, another display somewhere, on a movie screen, on a TV, on a laptop, pretty much anywhere you can display your imagery. Color calibration is a part of the pipeline that you have to master and be effective with to get a great result. Basically, there's two ways to properly color calibrate a monitor. You can use software or you can use hardware, or you can use hardware and software in conjunction. So three ways, but two tools. When using software to calibrate your monitor, that software actually measures the reference value against the measured values on your monitor based on the generated ICC profile and then adjusting the values to match both the reference and the measured to be as close as possible. Now that ICC profile, which stands for the International Color Consortium, is a set of reference numbers and values that should be accurate to the color space or color gamut that it is aligned with. So an sRGB will have certain values, a Rec 709 will have other values, and then a DCI-P3 will have another set of values. The software is basically using the ICC as a guide and trying to get as close to possible to getting them to match. The second way to color calibrate a monitor is to use hardware, like this colorimeter. This is a colorimeter, which is hardware, which has a USB attachment. You plug it into your computer, you open it up so the lens can see the screen, you hang it on the top of the screen, and you just attach this like a suction fish to the middle of the screen, and then run the software that comes with it, like the Dell Color Management software we'll be seeing in a little bit, and then let it run. If you search for your monitor on the Dell product support page, you can find the color management software under the drivers and downloads. The direct links are also in the video description below. Using this colorimeter, it will decide what's close enough and then adjust the values so it's perfect. So it's as close to possible to being the right colors in the right color space, the right color gamut for whatever you tell it to do. There are color spaces that are recommended for different artistic disciplines like still imagery, photography, graphic design, and then videography and film. Those require different color spaces, which I'll show you momentarily. I do this every month using this colorimeter, and that way I'm guaranteed to have accuracy across all of my monitors. Software is one way to do it. Hardware using the Dell Color Management software is the way I prefer to be absolutely accurate, which is what I critically need in my line of work. Sometimes, like on my previous 4K Dell monitor up here, it has a built-in colorimeter, which comes out, wipes the screen, does the analysis, then tucks itself back in, and then I'm ready to go. It takes about 10 minutes. It's very easy. It is more expensive to have it built in, but that monitor doesn't leave my studio, and it's been perfect for 5 years, and everything that I've graded has gone through that monitor up to this point. But now that I have the U4025QW, I'm ready to move on. All color calibration is not equal. Hardware calibration is superior to software calibration, but there's a way to test it so you can find out how close you're getting to perfect color. And that's using the Delta E. The Delta E is a measured standard that quantifies the difference between two colors displayed on a screen. Delta E goes from 1 to 100, with 0 being perfect and 100 being complete chaos, distortion, all colors blended together. We rarely see that. A delta E of less than 2 is considered optimal. A delta less than 1 is said to be indiscernible by the human naked eye to seeing a difference in the colors. So less than one is fantastic. Using my C6 colorimeter and Dell's new color management software, I measured a delta E of 0.67 on my new monitor. That is less than one. So that means basically the human eye can't tell the difference between colors and it won't affect me when I'm color grading, meaning I'm as close to perfect as I can get and I have numbers to prove it. With the monitor I'm calibrating today, my new U4025QW, I can choose between various color spaces, including sRGB, Rec. 709, Adobe RGB, DCI-P3, Rec. 2020, and I think Aces, I'm not sure, but maybe Aces. That would be all of them, all of the ones that are available. And as they get higher and higher in terms of color space, you're opening yourself up to being able to do more HDR work and more higher resolution work and into 10-bit and higher with billions of colors. So the larger the color space, the more demanding the monitor is and the more demanding the science and the calibration is to get it to be accurate. All right, here I've plugged my C6 colorimeter into my U4025QW and I'm gonna open up the Dell Color Management software and walk you through the steps needed to color calibrate. It's a lot easier than you think. So now that I've got everything open and started, I can see the dashboard where I can pick which color space I'm going to be using. On the Advanced tab, I can also choose the ICC profiles, which I just mentioned, which one we're gonna use, and also see my current settings so I know what my starting point is. I've opened up my colorimeter, I've taken off the diffuser, and I'm getting ready to place it on the monitor itself so we can get some accurate results. I can use the luminance, the brightness of my screen that I already have, or I can choose my luminance level, whatever that may be. Now I've started the calibration process. As you can see, the colorimeter is hanging in the one area that the colors will always be changing and updating. And the colorimeter will analyze the colors that the monitor is outputting and then make decisions based on the charts and the data to properly calibrate it and return the results to the computer to create a new ICC that is fully calibrated. The calibration is done and you can see we've hit 0.666, which we round up to 0.67, which is less than one, which means that the human eye cannot tell the difference between the colors and we've done a successful calibration. Now I've downloaded and installed the Dell Display Manager version 2. It's really nice, really flexible, and really powerful, enabling me to customize one monitor or all four of my Dell monitors for the right settings, for the right projects, and here's how that works. So I have about 8 different panels of which I can access anything from the current brightness and contrast of the monitor to how many ever monitors are plugged in. I can access any of those. The color, I can default to the color space that I prefer for everything, or which I find amazing is by using the auto function, I can actually choose per application which color space will be displayed during that process. So for me, Premiere Pro, my editing software, I want that to be DCI-P3 when I'm grading or working on feature films and high-end projects. If I was a photographer, I would set my Adobe Photoshop to a different color space. It could be Adobe RGB, it can be Rec. 709 if I'm going to the net, whatever I want. I can set up how my displays are positioned and in what order they come up in. If I have two computers set up to the same monitor, I can switch between those two. And the last option I really like is power nap. I can set the monitor to go to its lowest setting without turning off, so I can save some power, save the life of the monitor, and then I'm ready to go when I come back. So to wrap up this color space discussion, because it can be quite intimidating, I would say that for me included, Rec. 709 is the most popular and most safe color space to use, given the end product being something for the web, something for TV, something for a phone, something for a tablet, or even a movie screen. But Rec. 709 will give you the accurate representation that will be the most compatible with any device or location on the planet.
When I'm delivering projects for projection or a cinema theater, then I always use DCI-P3 because it has a larger color space, a wider gamut than both Rec. 709 and sRGB. With DCI-P3's expanded range, it's the perfect color space for me to deliver at the highest quality.
Just make sure to pick the right color space and calibrate properly before you start your project. Trust me, you'll be so much happier in the end, and everyone else will see all your hard work in all its glory. All right, well, that's it. I've color calibrated all my monitors using hardware and software and combinations of all those involved. They are accurate. They are even better than when they came from the factory. And I have now, again, peace of mind knowing that anything I produce, anything I create, and anything I send out in the world will have accurate colors that will be represented across anyone's device when they look at it. These are all components of being a professional colorist and a professional editor that I have to embrace, and I have to make sure that that pipeline is secure. Everyone else that's not doing it at the most professional level, just again, know that you're gonna have the peace of mind that you are showing the vibrancy and the color accuracy of your work, that the way you saw it, the way the camera saw it, that's how everyone else is gonna see it. And it's worth color calibrating your monitors to be able to share your work properly and let everyone else enjoy it. So that's the end of the video series. Thank you again for taking time to spend it with me. I hope I didn't ramble too much, but this was Color Calibration. I'm Vashi Nedimansky. Thank you for your time. Thank you to Dell for collaborating with me so I could express myself and share with you how it's done. And go out there and create and have a beautiful day. Ciao for now. Thanks again.